30 seconds.
All right, ready, VTA. One, you have the audience to pan.
25.
Two, you have the window to pull. Three, you're on the announcer.
20.
Well, it's always we ramble, this river and I. All along your green valleys I work till I die. My land I'll defend with my life need it be. Cause my pastures of plenty must always be free.
First, I want to thank everybody for coming out and showing your opposition to this plan. I appreciate everybody's doing the honorable thing. For those who don't know me, which is pretty much everybody, my name is Dan Newman, and I want to welcome everybody to this rally. We have come to the state capitol today to express our strong opposition to Governor Spitzer's plan to provide driver's licenses to illegal aliens. We are independents, Democrats, and Republicans, and until today, most of us had had little involvement in the political process beyond our civic duty to vote on Election Day. Some of us here are supporters of the governor, who had hoped for better judgment and a focus on the real problems facing the people of New York. Others are opponents of the governor. But I have invited both sides to be here today because regardless of your opinion of the governor only a month ago, we and millions of others across the state are now united in opposition to this plan. We all know that it is the job of the governor to take action in the best interests of the people of this state. The governor now knows that the vast majority of the people oppose this policy, yet he presses on. So I ask, if Governor Spitzer is not working for the people of New York, then for whom is he working? There are endless reasons why this policy is a bad one for the safety and security of this state, but beneath all lies the fundamental reason why we must not allow this irresponsible policy to move forward. It is wrong to reward illegal behavior with the privilege of a driver's license. There are others who are more knowledgeable about the issues of national and state security who will address those matters later. But as for the rest of us, we know that this is just plain wrong. The governor said that we should not ignore the problem of illegal immigration, and he's right. Solving the immigration crisis is an important national issue, but providing driver's licenses to illegal aliens is certainly not part of the solution. It is fundamentally wrong to reward those who violate our laws with a privilege of any kind. It is also wrong for the governor to characterize those of us who oppose this plan as immoral, unethical, bigoted, rabid, and anti-immigrant. Yet these are the words that Governor Spitzer uses to describe the majority of the people of this state. My message to the governor is simple. Please hear us and the millions who agree with us and withdraw this proposal. Work with those who oppose you and develop a more secure driver's license for those of us who are here legally. It is our belief that we need to work together to curtail the flow of illegal immigration into this state, and we must encourage those who are already here to begin taking steps on the path toward becoming legal and productive members of our society. Only then and through their own efforts should they be rewarded the privileges that we enjoy. And we ask you, Governor Spitzer, do you wish to be known as a governor of protest? Or would you rather be known as a man of compromise who brings the people of New York together in a common goal of making this a better place to live through wise and responsible policymaking? We need you to listen to the people, for the people have spoken. We have some great speakers here today to help us speak out to the governor. I'd like to introduce Senator Marty Golden. Senator, thank you.
Thank you very much. You know, we've been attacked for saying that they're putting out the fear card, that this is really not about terrorism. Well, shame on them. Because this is about terrorism. And this is about illegal aliens and sleeper cells here in the state of New York and across this great country. Muhammad Atta was stopped in Florida. His vehicle stopped with no license. He recognized how important it was to have a driver's license here in this country. And the 19 went out and got 38 pieces of identification, licenses and state ID cards. And then they proceeded to kill 3,000 people in this nation and cost hundreds of billions of dollars of carnage here in the city and the state of New York and across this country. It was recognized then by the 9/11 Commission that something had to be done. And the 9/11 Commission stated that you got to do something with your licenses. And lo and behold, the Real ID Act is passed in Congress and becomes law. Yes. We have the gold standard when it comes to licenses here in the state of New York. And I applaud the governor for taking some measures that would make it even a better document and a better gold standard here in the state of New York and for the rest of this country. And to be a leader, what we take of issue is thumbing down that license and not requiring social security numbers and allowing illegal aliens to get driver's license. I have to show that I have a social security number. An illegal alien does not have to show anything. There's a burden of proof on the citizen to have to prove that he is or she is who he or she is,
yes.
But not on the illegal immigrant. We should not be thumbing down this license. I am impressed that there is a facial scan, and I think that is a good first step. But we should have an iris scan or a fingerprint, not taking social security numbers away, but by increasing the status of this document, not by thumbing it down. This license, when you go to vote, all you had to do was show your license, right?
Right.
And you were allowed to vote.
Voter fraud!
This is a major, major problem in the state of New York, because the Board of Elections, they don't check to see if you're a citizen. They check to see if you voted twice. Now, with all these additional licenses here in the state of New York, hundreds of thousands of them, hundreds of thousands of vehicles on the roads of the state of New York, hundreds of thousands of licenses that would give the ability for these people to vote, the illegal aliens and the sleeper cells that we have here in the state of New York will get the gold standard and be able to do as they see best for whatever they wish to do. Whether it's to vote, whether it's to go out and to hurt the people of this city and this state by maiming them, killing them, or setting off some type of device that would hurt and kill many, like we've seen happen with those planes going into 9/11, that horrific morning. Ladies and gentlemen, this is wrong.
Yes.
I'm not going to call this governor any names. I think the governor's out there. The governor's got to make a tough decision. The people elected him. I'm asking the governor to rethink this. I think the governor should really take a look at why and who elected him. And to move backwards is not what the people of this great state elected him to do. They elected him to move forward.
Amen.
Governor Spitzer, listen to the people. 72% here. Listen to our police departments. Listen to our county clerks. Listen to the elected officials and move forward. Thank you.
First of all, I think it's important to thank Dan Noonan and Al Rooney from WGY and all the organizers of this event today. And especially to thank a good portion of those 72 to 73% of the citizens across the state who are opposed to this misguided policy. All these individuals who came out today. How about a round of applause for yourselves for that? We appreciate it. We all understand why we're out here today at this rally. We're here at this rally to protect the best interest in the security of this great state and this great nation against a mis-